Hey everyone, welcome to another video. In this video I'm gonna be trying out Alien Cosmetics, or as they are called now, Unearthly Cosmetics. I got the Fall Magic eyeshadow palette. I just got it in the mail, and I also got one of the liquid lipsticks, and I'm just gonna try it out today, do a look and give you my first impression thoughts. So let's get right into it. So as I said, I've never really tried this brand, but I have heard so many good things about it. The only thing that was kind of holding me back was their color stories are always a little bit out there, a little bit different, and I hadn't really seen one that was my thing, my style. And then they came out with the Fall Magic eyeshadow palette. I just love the outside packaging of this with the leaves, but they have some interesting colors. I also love the name, I mean Fall Magic, I love that name. And then inside we have a beautiful kind of colorful but also kind of neutral grungy fall color story. One of my shades came broken, I kind of pressed it back. I think I succeeded, I think it looks pretty good now, but I love the look of the shades in here. You can go green, you can go bronze, you can go neutral, you can go a little bit more purple, and I think all these shades will work very well together as well. So I already swatched this palette before I started filming, and all of these shades feel very, very soft. I'm kind of surprised that this was the only one that came broken, because they are so, so soft. The only shade that felt a little bit dry was the shade Bonfire. That one didn't feel as soft in the pan, but when I swatched this Cocoa shade, it almost crumbled out of the pan. So you have to be a little bit careful with this palette. The formulas in here are very soft, but this color story is just everything, especially for fall. Of course, fall is basically already over, we're going into the holiday season, but I still think this is gonna be a very pretty palette to use for that. So the shelf life of this is 36 months. It's pretty long, and it's made in the PRC, if you wanted to know that. This is an indie brand, and it happens a lot that indie brands are pressed by hand, that there's just a few people pressing it by hand and then shipping it out. This is made in the PRC, but I believe this is sent to you from the US, if I'm not mistaken. So I'm very excited to try this palette. I'm very excited to try this brand, because I think this brand has a lot of potential, and they come out with a lot of interesting releases. And I have a feeling that this could become one of my favorite brands. I mean, the swatches, the way this swatched, it looked so, so good, so shiny. I'm so excited. Then I also got one of the liquid lipsticks. I usually don't really buy liquid lipsticks. I'm not someone that buys a lot of liquid lipsticks from different brands, but I have heard very good things about this. I got the shade Autumn, and this is kind of like a darker rosy nude almost. It has a little bit of a hint of terracotta in there as well. It has a pretty basic packaging, nothing really special there. It just looks good. And then the Doe Foot is kind of like a flat one. We're gonna see how this is gonna apply. But I've heard Britt Clark rave about this formula. She raved and raved and raved about it. And after she said like 4 times that you have to try it, I was like, okay, if I order a palette, I will try a liquid lipstick. When I ordered this, the new liquid lips, the satin ones, they hadn't been released. But if I buy something else from this brand, I definitely want to try a satin one as well. But this is really a color that I could use quite often, that I could use on the daily. So that's why I got this one. And that's going to be everything for the products, the close-ups and the swatches. Now let's get into the eye look. So I zoomed you in a little bit. I already applied some eye primer. I just used my basic eye primer that I always use. And I was thinking what I wanted to do with this palette. And there are so many options here. There are so many looks that I want to do. But I think I want to do kind of like a two-tone look, with green kind of like on the outer part and then more bronze into the inner part, and see how that goes. That's something I haven't really done. I was just thinking of trying something new on my channel. So I'm gonna start out with the green in the outer part and then move on to the bronze. Or maybe I should put the bronze down first and then kind of blend the green into it. I think I'm gonna start with the shade Spiced and put that in the inner part of my crease. These eyeshadows have quite some kick up in the pan because they are so soft. As I said, you kind of have to be careful. So I'm just gonna pat this, blend this. This looks very pigmented, and it kind of blends itself, so that's good. I like how it looks. That took no effort at all. So let's just do the same on the other side. So this is a good start for sure. I'm not an expert in two-tone creases. It's not something I do a lot, but we're just gonna do it today. Now I'm gonna take a clean brush, but the same type of brush, and I'm gonna put the dark green in the outer part, and I'm just gonna put down the dark green first. If I feel like I have to blend it out a little bit, I can still do that, but I just wanna see how this one works on its own, because there's not really like a light green in this palette. Sometimes when I use a dark matte first, I get comments that that's not how you do eyeshadow, but listen, this is just a different technique. You can put down the deepest shade first, you can. If you want more pigment, if you want to have the true color, the true shade of that deep matte, you can put it down first. And I also do that a lot. It's just a technique that I like, especially with colorful shades. Sometimes you don't want your mattes to be influenced by putting a very light neutral shade underneath. Now I just want it to be green, so I put down the green first. I don't really see a lot of fallout yet, so that's good. I'm just gonna take the brush I used for the orange, kind of blending this. I don't want it to get muddy, but I do want it to look a little bit blended. This is a very pretty forest green, bit of a different color for me. I usually do more of an army green almost, or I do a teal. I feel like this is going very well with putting this down first. So I really like these mattes so far. Everything was very easy to do. Of course, it's a little bit of a tough color combination to blend into each other, but I think it looks good. Now I'm first gonna go into the green shimmer, this one called Leaves. And this is such a nice, shiny, bright green. This one is a little bit more on the teal side. And I feel like there's also a little bit of purple in here and a little bit of blue. It's almost, when I look at it like this, it almost looks like a multichrome. Wat was dat? Dat klonk echt als een baby olifant. When I look at it like this on my finger, it almost looks like a multichrome. It's that shifty. It looks so good. Just look at that. I feel like maybe this would have been better with a purple look. I didn't really realize, but this is a good thing because it will work very well with the purples. So I'm just gonna apply this with my finger towards the outer part. That's such a pretty shimmer. That is gorgeous. Just look at that shine and that shift. It looks so good. It is just so shifty. I just realized that my drawer might have been open for the first part of this video. I hope it was not. I hope I just did that. I don't know how this happened. It might have been open. Okay, let's do this to the other eye. This is such a gorgeous shifty shade. So pretty. And I'm just gonna take the shade Autumn over here. This kind of, it's almost like a very bright warm bronze with a bit of a pinky shift in there as well, but also a little bit of gold. These are just very interesting. I just swatched it over the green on my finger, but these are just very interesting shimmers with a lot of dimension in them. Also very, very shiny. So pretty. Adding that to this eye as well. This look is a little bit out there for me, but I'm kind of living for it. Especially for these videos, testing things out. I sometimes just want to do something a little bit different. Let's see what I'm gonna do for the lower lash line. I think I'm just gonna keep it a little bit simple because we already have two tones on the top. So I'm just gonna take this green shade, put it under my eyes, and then I might just take this shade Cashmere and put that towards the inner part of the lower lash line and see if it's light enough to maybe put in my inner corner. But I don't know if that's gonna work. So just smoking this out. Just gonna keep the bottom lash line green. I'm gonna clean up everything a little bit in a bit. I'm not being very precise with this shade right now. It's all my fault. So I'm gonna take a pencil brush and take that shimmer and put it over here. This is a little bit of a taupey shimmer, but it has a little bit of a hint of green in there as well. I don't think that this is gonna work under the eye, or in the inner corner, I mean. I don't think it's gonna work like that, so I'm just gonna grab something else in a bit to put in the inner corner. So this palette isn't like a one and done palette for me, but I don't really mind that. I don't really need an inner corner shade in every palette that I own. I think it's pretty easy to just grab your face highlighter and put that in your inner corner. So this is gonna be everything for the eye look. I'm just gonna clean up under my eyes a little bit, put on some mascara, do my brows, put on some bronzer and face makeup and things like that. And then for the last step of this look, we're gonna try on the liquid lipstick together. Okay, so let's move on to the liquid lip. I didn't put on a lip liner. I just want to see how this works without lip liner, how it looks without lip liner. Often liquid lips do work without putting down a lip liner first, so I just wanted to try if that is possible with this one. So I'm just gonna apply it. So I think this is a really pretty shade. It's a little bit more peachy on the lips than I was expecting. Maybe I would pair it with a little bit of a deeper lip liner, but I do really like it. It went on very easily. I just have to wait and see how this looks, how it feels when it dries down. It hasn't dried down yet, but so far I think it's pretty. I think it's a nice lip. Maybe it also looks a little bit lighter because I did this very vampy, very dark look on the eyes. Okay, I'm gonna wait a minute and then I'll be right back. So this is gonna be the finished look. The lipstick, it has almost completely dried down. It doesn't feel sticky at all. It feels slightly creamy still. It doesn't feel drying. Maybe there's like the slightest little bit of stick to it, but it feels pretty good. I have very dry lips right now, so I don't want to judge a liquid lip too harshly because I wouldn't really wear a liquid lip with the state my lips are in now, but I of course wanted to try it for this video. But it feels very good. Let me just... It transferred a little bit, but I prefer a liquid lip that transfers a little bit to a liquid lip that doesn't transfer and is so dry. So I don't really mind this amount of transfer, especially because when it transfers a little bit, it doesn't wear off right away. It doesn't mean that it isn't long wearing. Yeah, I think it feels good. Of course, I have to try it a little bit, do a little bit of a wear test. I'm gonna leave it on and update you in a comment if I remember. I hope I remember. I have a bit of a busy week ahead of me. But yeah, all in all, I really enjoyed everything that I tried today. I think the eyeshadows that are used are really pretty. The shimmers are so shiny, textured and dimensional. Especially the shine on these is amazing, and I thought the mattes blended very well. I didn't try a lot of the mattes. I have to try this palette a little bit more. I always come back to you and rank my new makeup purchases after I've used everything a little bit more often. So I've really made up my mind and can really share my thoughts. This is just the first impression. This is just how I feel after using everything once. That's not a lot. You always have to try things a little bit more, I feel, to really know if you like it. But so far, really enjoyed these eyeshadows. I think this look is so pretty, and the green blended out very well even without a transition shade underneath, so I'm also really happy about that. So yeah, I think this brand has a lot of potential for me. I think it's a very cool brand. They have such good vibes, and I can definitely see myself trying more. So that is gonna be everything for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments if you've tried anything from this brand. Is there anything you think I should pick up? And of course, like this video if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe. And then I will see you in my next one. Bye bye.